So that big monitor I flashed in several of my videos. LG approached me and offered to try out their new 49-inch 5K ultra-wide monitor. I'll be honest, outside of this situation, I would probably never consider ultra-wide and curved monitor, because both ultra-wide and curved scared me. Until I tried it. The main purpose of such a form factor is productivity. I can easily divide the screen into several parts and have all the necessary media in front of me when working on something. In Cinema 4D and Octane combo, this form factor is particularly useful as nothing becomes small. I have even distribution in my working spaces. I can see all the details in the viewport, all the details in the live render, and have full unobstructed access to all my tools. LG guys were aware of my pickiness in color reproduction and the importance of a good monitor in your workflow. So they allowed me quite a lot of time with the monitor before making any conclusions. Hence why you've seen this monitor in several of my previous videos. I spent almost 3 months with it. For me personally, this solution is much better aesthetically than two side-by-side monitors because there is no gap in between them. The monitor is curved. You know that curved screens were really controversial innovation back in the days, but the curve actually makes sense in the monitor because you are sitting right in front of it and you can feel the curve. This whole experience will take some time to get used to though. At first, I was really frustrated and I started to really enjoy it only after a couple of days of use. What quite surprised me was the speakers. It's quite a decent upgrade to your laptop speakers. My monitor is facing the wall, so I guess there is some kind of bouncing enhancement happening as well. Anyways, good balance between lows and highs, perfect for background music while working on something. Colors. Colors are very good, considering LG never claimed this is a color accuracy beast. Featuring IPS panel, this monitor gives you 99% of sRGB coverage, 350 nits of brightness. For a monitor, it's quite bright. It will be perfectly visible in a sunny environment. My environment is quite dark, so I'm keeping it at about 200 nits. Anti-glare matte coating is a feature I like to have in all my screens. So that's very good. You won't be distracted by annoying reflections and all that stuff. Connectivity. On the side you have two USB ports and a headphone jack. At the bottom you have USB-C port with 85 watts of power, another two USB ports, two HDMI ports, and a display port which will serve as your main input. No SD card reader, which can be found on a lot of professional monitors these days. It's a bummer, but absolutely fine. You also have a fancy joystick to control all your settings. Works fine and is quite convenient. Design wise, it's really sexy, but I don't like the white finish on the back. If I would want to bring this monitor to our studio, it would completely destroy my black on black style, so I would really want this monitor in full black. The stand. I'm not using the stand, I'm hooking my monitor to the wall, but I've put it on a stand for you guys to show the monitor. It's really high quality, it looks good, and again too bright for my particular style. Final notes, if you're thinking about getting one of those, make sure to research what softwares LG offers on their website. For example, screen splitting in Windows limits to 4 sections, but LG's on-screen control app allows you different layouts, so you can divide your screen in 8 sections. Whatever layout you like the most is possible with their app. Also, this monitor doesn't offer a feature when you can control several devices hooked to the monitor, but you can do this with LG's dual controller app. It would be particularly useful for me at work when I have my laptop hooked and my big workstation hooked to the same monitor. To be honest, I struggled to find these apps on LG's website, so in order to reduce your pain, I included all the links in the video description. Conclusion. I like this wide format a lot, and I'm thinking about moving this monitor to our studio to use with my reference monitors. This is a really huge desktop to fit all the necessary media on your screen. But I will have to think how to fit it in there without exposing that back white panel. Hope my review was informative enough and you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section. LG guys are reading, I'm reading, and we will reply if we can. Thank you for watching. Peace.